John here. Today is Monday, the 7th of June 2016. Just update. What's the latest? I'm just working on the 77 Cook Street property, seizure, and to Subpoena Prime Minister John Key. You listen to this video, this one's for you. I'm holding you liable for the fraud that's going on in this country, because at the end of the day, you should be checking your law system to make sure nothing slips through the net. It's no good waiting till the fraud has occurred. In this case, the foreign companies running private businesses here, and as well as your private businesses as well, are running the racket with those other fraudulent companies in the Panama tax havens for business going on here in this country. You're liable, John Key, because you've allowed this to happen inside your government while you're governing this country with Jerry Matapurai Andrews, Governor General. I'm holding him liable. I'm subpoenaing him and you, John Key, and Amy Adams, the Minister of Justice, and the Police Minister, Judith Collins, into Auckland District Court through Watangi, Marae, King's Bench Court, under the Admiralty of this flag, here, the King William flag, jurisdiction. Now, you have to come up with an answer in this Auckland District Court. We're transferring the online court case that I'm conducting here with these documents that I'm putting together for you and other people, the landowners of Cook Street, 77 Cook Street, James Pierce Brown, Simon Brent Roundtree. Your names have been bandied all over the world, caught up in the same fraud as what John Key has allowed this country to conduct that racket inside Parliament, making statute laws that allowed fraud to occur. Right, that's what I'm saying to my chief, Kingi Taurua, in Waitangi, as the chief of Waitangi lands. Right, we're confiscating those back as a consequence of the Navy not replying to us in writing to renew their contract. You are all operating private businesses under this flag, John Key, because there's no other queen or king that has this power from Westminster Parliament. Okay, so I'm holding you for everything they've done wrong. Your ministers have not been checked. There's no checks and balances of running a shoddy government here in front of me. Now, I'm watching what's happening in Westminster and also in America with the Queen and her titles under this flag. I'm telling everybody on Facebook who I am, where I come from, in Ireland, Northern Ireland. That's my Pākehā white man's Cosgrove family, Irish and Rogan, Irish and English. Rogan families to hear in that title of the League of Nations at that time to this flag of King William, right? Now get this straight, that you liabled those ministers, they liabled you back. You are playing the same libeling game that we now have the Pope destroyed all your trusts and corporations, and you're still using it. That's one point. But the main thing is this flag is only for our use with the Admiralty law, court-martial, and a state of emergency. If we put a state of emergency on this country, you're in it. As soon as I get no reply from you, John Key, you must put in writing to counter-claim my affidavit of claim to this country. We're taking our authority back, John Key, of this country, because you can't produce a title beside the Maori title and King William's authority to jurisdiction over you and the use of Admiralty mortgage liens and bank notes, bank and trade. You have nothing to show me. You have to put it in writing, who you get your authority from, who you swear your oath of office to, and where's your seal to operate your private companies without this flag. You find your own peace of mind, because this is mine. This is my authority with Kingi Taurua and his chief's elders in Waitangi. They are watching what I do. The whole world is watching what I do, John Key. I know what I'm doing, because I've been assigned to do this job from Ngāpuhi. They are the ones, the main contractors here, first party to King William the Fourth, Westminster Parliament. You are a second party to the absent Queen of Brussels now. Now you have to front up with something good enough. I'm only going to give you a certain amount of time to do it in. And if you can't come up, we take you out. We take you out, we're stripping you already on this bill, the Lien debtors pound note bill, with £1 trillion on your head, each of your ministers' heads, and every other voter in this country, John Key. They all got £1 trillion on their heads as payment for the consequences of ignoring Kingi Taurua and his chiefs in Te Tihi Marae, Waitangi, on his land blocks. You're on his land blocks, John Key. You only occupy them. The same as 77 Cook Street to those landowners there, James Pierce Brown and Simon Brent Roundtree. You only occupy the land. You cannot produce an original title. I'm holding them here. Okay? I'm holding them on behalf of Ngāpuhi, the first contractors to King William the Fourth. Now, you're a second party, third party, John Key. You're a third party when I have already given you notices that you've ignored, totally ignored everything I'm saying, yet we have the King, the seal and the flag of Admiralty to go with our documents. We have a Marae statue that Queen Victoria took to England, the first one of all the Marae statues stolen off East Island as our native title, John Key. Now, you are Austrian, English born. You better get your titles ready in front of mine, the Wanoa, Rogan, Cosgrove titles. Right? Tom Cosgrove was in the League of Nations as one of the spearheads in behind the Patrick family and the Stewart family that were putting this title together with those three families, John Key, and the Wanoa family here in New Zealand, and East Island, and Raiatea Island, Tahiti. Okay? And not forgetting Tainui and Ngāti Porou and Ngāpuhi makeup of Tahitian title to what I'm talking about. I'm talking for them and our existence here on these lands, John Key. We are the original owners of this land that you're trying to buy out from buying your own self, Maori. This is Moai I'm talking about. It's all over my Facebook as evidence against you. It's acceptable evidence in the High Court of Admiralty in London, and we can do our court hearings online, and that's where you're going to. You could, first of all, we are putting you online in Waitangi King's Bench Court, Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court, you, John Key, Jerry Monteparai, for fraud and treason and ignoring the chiefs up there and defrauding the public of New Zealand and our native Moai people, New Zealand and Pacific Islands. So to all the people watching this video this morning on Monday, 7th of June 2016, the day after Queen Elizabeth's birthday, I'm just telling you, I'm holding you on this video as a sworn affidavit of verbal notice to you that I'm subpoenaing you into Auckland District Court through Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court, through the chiefs and myself, the sheriff of those lands and the lands of Auckland, for the meantime, the whole country. We're taking it back off you, John Key, because you've defrauded the land itself with shabby court law and trying to cover it up by saying you're going to tighten the laws. Don't you think it's tight enough as it is now without any more gaps and holes in it. It's got too many holes in it, Jonky, and you're filling the hole with you and a levy debtor notice on your head today. And all your ministers in the parliament, 121 of you, get a £1 trillion note on your head from today and before. Just update that I mean business against the pound note, Marae King William IV pound note. That's up against you. You're stripped of all your titles if you can't answer me in an affidavit. The same as Jerry Matapurai, never answered my letters, my affidavit letters, or any letter. None of you ever did. Now I'm going to force the issue on you to come up with an answer. You must come and up an answer, and the judge is only there for the court. The court requires you to counterclaim my claim against you. The same as your Minister of Police, Judith Collins, I'm holding you liable for your policewoman, Natalie Flower Dewey Brown, is incompetent. You've got incompetent people and fraudsters running your police force in New Zealand. The CIB, the worst of all. The ones I'm holding against you are Aaron Pascoe, detective, senior investigator of crime. He's a criminal himself in his own crime position. And also Tim Duthie, Detective Tim Duthie, and Natalie Flower Dew Brown, Detective. Those three who offended me and call me this and that. Right? They've libeled you by doing that to me, the title holder in this country. One of them responsible to hold you account to anything going wrong with our land. These are our lands, Jonky. You and your immigrants, that's what they're saying in America now. All those people are immigrants, the white people that came to America, they're getting told the black people are going to clean that lot up. Well, not so much here, but we're just putting the law on you now that Britain and is pulling out of the EU where you've got yourself with those elite people in there. You're going to get the bill. They're all going to get the bill. And now the Queen wants to double back from the EU and go back to Britain. Too late. Too late. She's caused enough trouble to us here in New Zealand. And not only Maori, but everybody here that's been duped out with your law to your own private use, Jonky. You've got the law on your own private self-interests and your private companies against us, the landlords of this country, and the public of New Zealand. You've defrauded them, and that's treason. Right? I'm holding you a lot of things I might miss here on this video, but they're all in writing documents. All those documents are legal, Jonky. I'm legal. I'm calling myself legal sheriff. I'm going to ring Kingi Taurua now, see how he's getting on. The chief in Watangi, that I might have a meeting with him soon. Just waiting for the Prime Minister of Maori government, Sunakura, to call me as well. Here goes. I hope you can hear. Oh, I can't pick it up. Kingi! Kia ora mano. Just a hello call, that's all. Nothing much, what? I'm good. I'm all fit now in the gym. I'm pushing the weights up and down. I'm keeping up with all those Rarotongans. Hey? I threw the pills aside for a month to see what difference it makes. And I tell you what, it made a big difference. Yeah. Now they kill you off. I've been reading up on it, and it does slow you down and make your legs not work properly. Make you feel tired and depressed and but especially it can't function properly. You know, your brain go in reverse. Now I go up every day. For 3 hours I go in the gym and 1 hour in the pool. Yeah, but you know, just to get myself back together, and we got a lot of things to do yet, Kingi. Yeah, we've got a lot of work. Me and you got a lot of work to do. But I know, I don't worry about anybody else up there now, just you. And it's up to me to do my bit over here and make the next bit go. I'm not worrying about Sue too much. I'm just keeping on track with what I do with you up there. And we got a big audience, eh? Yeah. But I think it. Yeah, you're better to make your own regime to get yourself right, and don't let anybody change your mind. That's what I did now. And the nurse came to see me, and she didn't realize I wasn't taking my pills, and she said, the readings look good. And I won't tell her. I won't tell her. When she come back again, she'll be surprised, because I'm fit. But I made some video and put it on YouTube, and you can see me pushing those big weights. No trouble. He's on YouTube. I'm feeling better, and you know, I can think better about what I'm doing, and we got a big audience following us, Kingi, you know, watching what's really going on, and it didn't matter about what anybody else says. They can't do much about anything, because it's in that marae, and you and me and the document to finish it off. And that's all. You just wait till I get clicked in here. Shouldn't be too long to get things going. But I have to subpoena John Key into the court in Auckland District Court. That's what I'm doing now. He's liable for what's been going on with those fraud coming through here. He's a bit shabby on his law, allowing that fraud to happen when he's playing around with it too. So. When I get a bit closer, it's looking good so far. They're going to have to listen to us before long. And that's all I call for, just to tell you I'm Mr. Hercules, right? Okay. See ya. All right. There you go. That's the chief. Kingi Taurua, the chief. I just spoke to him to tell him I'm Mr. Hercules, Mr. John Key. I can lift big weights before long, and your pills have been killing me. I'm going to have you for that too, you and your doctors and all your people who are making sure I die slowly. No, not anymore. I'm going to drag all those old people into the gym and make them go and get a life. That's why it's on YouTube. You'll see me on YouTube pushing those weights over there. I'm going up there soon. That's my regime. I go there to get fit so I can deal with a lot of issues of everything you're doing, John Key and Jerry Matapurai. You're not going to run away to England without me and Kingi having a last terror strip out of you, because he didn't like what you're doing to him and his lands up at Waitangi, sitting on his lands and selling it off. And you're going to go to England, Jerry Matapurai, Governor General, you're going to go to England and sit there and sell the rest off. Your Maori land is going to get a bill from the Maui land, HAPU. And your Maori iwis, you're going to get the bill too. £1 trillion on each of their heads. I'm serious. The British are watching me. They're watching me from over there in Ireland and Scotland and England and Wales. And they're going to take this seriously. What I'm saying, to claim back everything that you have sold here, John Key. Your mischief, you're getting away with. I'm putting a list of everything. I've got two sites against you, John Key, on Facebook. It's acceptable evidence in the High Court of Admiralty in London and on Watangi, Marae, King's Bench Court. It's evidence in there. Everybody's reading what I'm saying, John Key. We've got two sites there with all of your fraud activities and everything you're lying about. That people are making comments. There's too much stacked up against you. It's not worth getting another Prime Minister to replace you, because that one will be the same as well. You just bounce from one to the other. Every year, year in, year out, you go backwards and forwards. We're going to chop that in half. Big changes coming. You won't be able to do any of that anymore. The Greens and the Labour, no. That's going to happen the same way. You're going to just spin the whole lot and the fiat money go around. Right? You're going to get the bill. I'm going to show everybody how you did it. I'm going to show my barrister how you did it. And he's feeding off the name they call John Wanoa. Right? That's a private company they're using. Identikit of me to defraud me of the money they're paying themselves to the lawyer, the barrister of that company. The judge, the police, right, and the government is helping themselves to my name, likeness. I'm going to subpoena, well, Natalie Flower Dew Brown, John Key, you appointed the policewoman, Judith Collins, to administer that department. Now, they're all fraud. I'm saying the police are fraud. All of you people propping up your businesses in the private, and the judge has to take my word for it, because I'm holding title with Kingi. That's what he just told me. John, it's between me and you. See? So I clear with him, and I've been online with Hohepa, Epiha. He's looking after his taumata on the other side. He was in that Waitangi Marae on the 15th of March 2016. Open up that King's Bench Court for business. We're in business, John Key. We're in business. Oh, my flag is falling over. Anyway. Right. We're in private business, John Key. I'm in a private business with that name, John Wanoa. I'm claiming it as an inheritance to anything that's been made into money. That's my name, John Key. If I've got to find who countersigned my bond, bail bond, to come out of prison, who countersigned it and is picking up the money? That's fraud. That's fraud. Straight fraud through your government and you, I'm libeling, and that person who signed it. I want to know who signed that. And no matter what, I'm putting the £1 trillion note of the whole lot of you. All of you and your voters. Take note that everybody in New Zealand is now liable if you're voting for anybody in Parliament in New Zealand. And Pacific Islands for that matter. Because Moai and King William goes right through the Pacific Islands. Okay? We'll get to America yet, because they need this flag. To those people who are watching in America, we've got a few people there, and Jean, Odine, up in Maine, Portland. She's watching what we do here after leaving New Zealand and went back to Hawaii and then back to Maine. She'll be with us at some stage sooner or later to document. She's documenting everything we do, and very good at the videos that she's made of NZ Invest, your companies, John Key, those private companies, 80, about 86 of them, are in this same racket that I'm saying. Those videos in Tapora Street, in the city, and Mahuhu Crescent, are made with Jean Odine about the NZ Invest and your companies, and especially the company that Jerry Matapurai is the president of, Waitangi National Trust. That company is getting the biggest bill out of the 970 million trillion trillion pound note. The green pound note, John Key, is right up against that Marae trust. Okay? And you're liable. You've libeled him, and he's libeled you and you're both liable to the Queen, and the Queen's liable to you, because she's fraud too. Right? She's carrying that head above the judge's head in the court. That's what I'm saying to my barrister. Who is he swearing his oath to? That woman above his head, or something else? What's her head doing up there when she's not the Queen in England? She's the Queen in Brussels. John Key, it's a conflict of interest. You're a conflict of interest. You're a big risk to us, the people of New Zealand, that is not in your system, or in the Moai system, or otherwise waiting to pick which is going to be the ruling factor here. Your Admiralty or my Admiralty and my Chiefs, John Key. It's going to be one or the other. And just tell this notice to the British military, our partners, first party, and you, John Key, third party. You're a third party because the natives here are the second party. Natives, not Maori, the native Hapu are the second party, the native. Okay? And everybody else is third party. Right? Those police that got in my road on Cook Street, I'm going to take that property as the sheriff, John Key, because I have the authority from Kingi Taurua and the other elders up there, driven by Puhepa Epiha. Right? 39 Hapu Marae in Ngapui. This is their title, John Key. This is their contract, private contract with King William. Just play. Right? You got nothing of a private contract with anybody. Right? You've only got the Treaty of Waitangi, which is a fraud document anyway. It's got no end date. Any contract to anybody watching this video, any contract that has no end date on it, in agreement, that's one of them. It's fraudulent document. And they don't care about anybody here of what that means. I'm just telling you, it's fraud. And that's another thing I'm putting up against you, John, and libeling you for that too. All the money that's been made from that document and using this without our authority, if you're caught to be using this without our authority, without coming to see us, and your Navy is using this without coming to see us the last time we wanted to meet them in that marae, and John Martin, the Chief of Navy, decided to stay in Fiji and look after those people over there in the disaster they set up themselves. The elite set up the Pacific to sink, and earthquakes and tidal waves and tsunamis and all those bad things. They created that. They created all the havoc in the world, and they're creating this ISIS in the world. The Queen, your Queen, John Key, is behind the racket in America to take it back to Britain, right? It's all a merry-go-round, and it's all this control fraud, right? I'm having you up for fraud, John Key. I'm having Jerry Matapurai Andrews, Governor-General, up for fraud before he goes to England. So that when he gets there, the British military will pick him up and lock him up, or hang him, in this case, with this flag's jurisdiction of Admiralty Court Martial Law. Right? Kingi Taurua is his partner in the Vietnam War. They went to war together. So Kingi is a military man that's behind what I'm saying as a sheriff. We go hand in hand in that court, and we know what we're doing. We both know what we're doing. And there are people who are watching and following us as well. It's a statement of confidence. This is a statement of confidence, John Key. It is the statement of confidence. You've got nothing. Your Supreme Court you opened up has got no statement of confidence from Westminster Parliament. This one has. It's old, John Key. It's 182 years old, this, in Westminster. All right? I'm saying this in confidence of myself, putting the history together, and putting the titles together, and putting the claims together. Not the treaty claims, because those are fraud as well. You're paying yourselves back to your iwis, and they're keeping it to themselves and nothing for the hapu. This is hapu. This is for the natives, or all the natives in the world. This flag represents the Confederation of Chiefs and those indigenous countries that are looking for something to England. This is it. This is the authority that will give you Americans and Indians there, and Canada and Australia and Britain and Africa and India, this flag here will give you back your independence, because it is an independence flag of sovereignty, and it is a trading bank of England flag of the pound note. Okay, that's what I wanted to tell you. That today I'm putting this, drafting these letters, and you'll see it's 575 pages so far. Case against Natalie Flowerdew Brown, but I'm putting it into a template so that it will go right across anyone in the world. Okay, we're running the Moai King William Commonwealth Government of the World under this flag, and this document I'm doing is a template for that in Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, the Waitangi Marae itself. Okay, so Kingi Taurua, you're watching this video, I'm just saying the authority comes from that marae on these lands, as the marae set aside from all the other marae's as being the authority to Britain, and the Admiralty of King William the Fourth flag, pole, staff, mast in the paddock next to the marae. That's our King's authority that's controlling mortgage liens, bank loans, and the pound note. Okay? So for you, all you people, we're going to get there soon. We're going to, it's been a long time for me to put these together because I've been getting my health right. And you'll see me on videos on YouTube and Facebook doing that at the same time as putting all the documents together, keeping a track on the history of what's happening in America, Britain, and the world for that matter, and where is the elite going up against the wall against Putin and the New World Order. The Pope trying to bring in the New World Order from something out there. And it's not going to work, Mr. Pope Guglio, Bergoglio, Pope Francis. To you. This video is to you. You won't get away with it, because we already know you're crooked as hell inside a church. Not the church's fault, it's your fault for making all this racket happen around the world with money. You and your money and your churches, Satan, ISIS, right? The Antichrist and all the rest of the bullshit that's floating around the world. People have got their Jesus, that's theirs, it's not yours. It's for those people who they had and you took it and screwed it up with the Queen and use Jesus and God all the way through in your courts to make your laws and your parliaments here. I'm holding you to that too, John T, using God on your Bible to swear your oath of office to, and then swear to something else now, like Melbourne in Australia, New South Wales. They said that in Victoria, they swear to the law. Well, where's the Queen gone and all of that, you see? You don't want the Queen, and now you want to use the Queen again when she goes back to Britain. Not going to work, because we're getting rid of her. I'm going there to get rid of the Queen, because she's made too much death with her name and her string of offences against the indigenous people of the world, just for money. Just for money, wealth, greed, gold, and all the rest of it. We're taking it off you. We're stripping the whole lot off you. Not only me, everybody following us with this flag around the world. We'll get the tidal turbines going at the East Coast here, and an island. I'm going to Ireland with Jamie, and we're going to stitch our families together. The Patrick family on her side, and I'm Jamie, Anna Marie, Patrick, Stuart, Ngātai. Okay, so that's a group of names of the clan in Northern Ireland, where I come from, my clan, come from the same area, Ulster, the Cosgrove Irish, and the Rogan Irish, comes from there, the brains of the League of Nations, and what's happened, took their brains into Westminster. Okay, that's the part I'm interested in, the law part of their brain, John Key. That's on our side. We're the ones that are putting all this together to show we've got title over there and here. Now, where's yours? You've got to go back to Austria and get yours. You'll find it's mixed up with the Jews and stealing land and everything with those Germans. right? You're stealing this, that and everything, and put your name on it as if it's you. You and your Maori iwi, John Key, they're going to get a bill too. And everything, the Waikato River, all that pollution in there, that's your private business that did that, and their private business, Tainui's private business, the iwi. The hapu got nothing much out of it. I'm here for the hapu. I'm here for the people of New Zealand. Not only the hapu, but the hapu has a lot to do with the land itself. It's their land you're playing with, John Key. They want to get you in the court and take everything off you. We're going to clean it off you. I'm taking the sheriff's position of the King of England, the King of Britain, UK, okay? And his successor, King Ernest Augustus of Britain and England, and New Zealand, Pacific Islands, and the world for that matter. He'll be going in to take your place, Queen, because that's what I'm going there for, to put him in on his own land in Devon, England. King of Hanover, that's what I was looking for, that word. King of Hanover in Devon, to Devon here, Port. Right? All that history belongs to us, John Key, and King William, our contract partner. And the British military, our contract partner. We're not libelling them so much, but we're holding them to account to go and salvage everything off you in your Queen's Bench Court, John Key. That's what I'm in the Auckland District Court for. Why are they taking so long to take me into court? Right? They're going to use my shirt with the King William's authority on it, his statement of claim and his monarch coat of arms on it, and his flags on it, and his face on it, and you stole it. John Key, your policewoman stole it. I'm holding you liable for her behaviour and your behaviour in front of the world, selling this place off and selling it to the TTIP, Trans-Pacific Partnership Agreement, TTPA. You're selling it to them and you haven't even got a title. You haven't even got a title. So they'll get the bill too. Everyone that's a third party or fourth party, fourth party gets the bill, £1 trillion each. We just go straight across the board. We've got a blanket claim. Right? Make this public. Everything I'm saying on this video is a verbal statement of affidavit. I, John Hawani Kahaki Wano, swear to tell the truth, nothing but the truth, so help me God. I'm telling the truth in front of you all on the video on this day as the sheriff, on behalf of my native people here in New Zealand and Pacific Islands, and King William IV. I swear my oath office to King William IV and my ancestors. Alright? There. That's my affidavit to you in this video today. And to add to that, I just put a timeline on this, that before Jerry Matapurai goes to England in November, and before the Navy, the US Navy comes here and throws their racket around here and signs documents again with you, John Key, behind closed doors where no one can see, in the private. You won't be using this private law on us. We're going to do this before the US ever comes here, because they'll be party to this flag as a conflict of interest with the Queen's head operating that business over there through King George III. And King William IV is in New York. That's where he set his business up. That's where Prince Andrew went as trustee to Queen Victoria Trust. That's our trust, John Key. I'm going to salvage all of that back. The gold trust as well. All the gold, all their gold is missing. Over 100 million tons of gold missing. We're going to salvage all that back. And everything the King's Bench owns in the King's Bench Court in that Marae at Watangi. Right, that's my statement to you. To Sue Nakora and Desmond and Georgie Job down in Maniapoto, I'm just still waiting for Sue to call me on this video for the native government. coming in to take your place, John Key. Or otherwise, I'm bringing the British military into Rangitukia, on our land blockade, to come and clean you out of the beehive in Wellington. We're going to clean you out. We had enough of you and your mob in there, of thugs. No more. No more. You're going to lose everything. That's what I want to say in the video. You lose everything as a consequence of your fraud. It's the fraud that got you in trouble, John Key. You'll have to contest my allegations against you in an affidavit, clear, precise affidavit of your title against my title, John Key, in front of the whole world watching. Our court cases are online in front of the whole world. Those 68 websites I've got on Facebook and the YouTube is enough that the judge, Collins, says to my barrister, why does John want to tell him something? And the judge says, well, it's all on YouTube. There, rest my case. Everything's out. There's nothing to pick, John Key. There's nothing to look for because I'm saying everything truthfully in front of God. Now, no more lies in front of me, John Key. And Jerry Matapurai, you too. You're not going to slip away out of New Zealand and go and carry on the racket in England because they'll be waiting for you over there. All those people watching these videos, watching me, you're not going to get away with the US Navy. You're not going to get away with coming here and expressing their court-martial law on us when we already got it. You haven't got it. You haven't got the authority higher than the King of Admiralty, court-martial law. You haven't got the authority higher than this flag. Anyone in the world. This flag will save Britain. It'll be going up there in Devon on King of Hanover's land, King Ernest Augustus. If you're watching this video, this one's for you. I'm still waiting for you to reply to me anytime now to take your position in Westminster and boot the Queen out. I'm coming there to boot her out as the Sheriff of the county in Devon, England, on King William the Fourth's property. I'm doing that here, straight to where his ship is standing on high ground, solid earth ground, dirt in Waitangi, on Kingi Taurua's land. Alright, John Key, you have to get off that land. That's what I'm saying. I'm going to put you off the land because I'm the sheriff. That's all. The sheriff is the master of every law of King William's. Alright, King William's law, it's for the people, common law, and that's our law, and our own Marae law. Okay, thank you very much. That's what I want to say for now. I better get on with it and go to the gym, get spruced up, and I hope you're enjoying these movies as much as others in Britain and America watching. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.